brand new stadium, a big one, and they're going to put a big flag up there in a moment because the Eagle has landed for the Premiers in 2018.
Incredible day, and what a victory for the West Coast Eagles. Hello, I'm Damian Barrett, and welcome to Access All Areas. Jimmy Bartel and Matthew Lloyd, that was one epic contest.
Yeah, an absolute beauty, Damo and Lloydie, but I feel like the best side for the year won. I know we wanted the fairy tale, and Collingwood were on this, I guess, great ride to maybe win the premiership, but you go through it, they were never really outside the top two. They rattled off 8 wins in a row, never lost in Victoria, and had all Australians everywhere. They beat Richmond and they beat all the sides in the top 8. A very deserving winner.
Best grand final we've had, Damo, since 2010. And obviously, they kicked the first 5 goals, Collingwood. But after that, I think from quarter time, West Coast were the better side. They kept chipping away, and it took to the last 2.5 minutes to finally get there.
Best grand final since 2010. And yeah. I think of the relatively modern era, it's got its own place amongst the all-time great grand finals. I mean, you go back to 1989, I think, for the all-time epic one. But I think it sits very comfortably as a contest amongst any grand final we've had since that time.
Yeah, it was two different styles. It was almost a tick to the traditional setup. West Coast had the two big forwards, two rucks, two key backs. You know, we've seen in the last couple of years, it's been a lot of small forwards and that manic pressure. And Collingwood played that way, and West Coast doubled down on the way they played. You mentioned it, Lloydie. Yeah. They kept chipping away, over 100 marks. They kept to their style, and it ended up wearing down Collingwood in the end.
And I thought, Damo, it was Collingwood's midfield who has got them to this position. Yeah. But it was that area that got them probably beat.
Really?
I thought West Coast just overpowered them as the day unfolded.
And look, we had the storyline of the tearaway leader and then the team coming back, and it all came down, didn't it, to the final moments when it needed a hero, and Jeremy McGovern presented himself as that man. You can see the time there, 2 minutes 45 to go. Treloar grabs the ball and lobs it into the forward line. And, Lord, I take it over from here.
Yeah, he left Jordan to go in. I thought Jordan needed to go with him. He didn't. But even this kick, what a beautiful kick that was. He pierced Collingwood players. Vardy hits up. Another one, Liam Ryan, just a beautiful mark. Had a tough day, went back with the flight, showed courage, which he didn't earlier in the day, which we'll show later on. Tom Langdon, need to be up. He lets him roll off, and then we'll talk about this later. But over to Dom Sheed, great block by Rioli. And he nails it.
Yeah, it was a great block, but to go a drop punt, and I've heard Dom Sheed talk, you know, everywhere. Of course, everyone wants to know about how confident he was, but coming out of the old Subiaco change rooms, that's where they do their shots, where the strength and conditioning guys are trying to, pull you off the training track. They just sit there and kick snaps and drop punts. So he was certainly confident.
Amazing composure, wasn't it? Because he had time to think about ramifications for that kick. But it wasn't just the kick itself that went through. I mean, his form since Andrew Gaff went down has just elevated itself into a really elite running player. So disposals, clearances, inside 50s and ground ball gets since Gaff went down have been extraordinary for Dom Sheed.
Yeah, there was a period there where he was getting 10 and 11 disposals through the middle part of the year, and he became a 30-plus player by the end of the season.
All right, you mentioned, Lordy, you alluded to it, the actual last play where Sheed took the mark. Was it a free kick to Maynard?
I did say great block, meaning hit the thought process to do it for his teammate, but I think it's a free kick. You've got to give a player a fair run at the ball, and he didn't do that.
All right, Lloydie, so Rioli, he's entitled, though, to make contact in the marking contest. At what point does it then turn into a free kick?
Well, I think if he's going back at the ball there, well, that he can do that, but he wasn't going for the ball.
I think the fact he didn't go for the mark, Jimmy, it means it was a free kick. And again, it's a hard one for the AFL, and we're not going to dwell on this too long, because I think if they paid that free kick to Maynard, they'd be comfortable in saying it was the right decision. The fact it wasn't paid, I don't have a major issue with it in the context of that game, the way it was umpired. Look, there were so many things had to go right for the Eagles after Collingwood got away to a 29-point lead. They had, I suppose, a relatively unconventional forward line, didn't they, throughout the season? And then they even went taller during the course of this game.
Yeah, I may mention that, the two tall forwards. But then what they did was they started the game actually with Cripps around the back of the square. So we've seen a lot of sides do it. Centre bounce, you send the forward around. But because Collingwood's pressure was so good and, you know, the quick kick comes forward, we saw Langdon be very dominant across half-back. A lot of intercept marks, a lot of possessions. So what they did was they actually started to swap their ruckman from forward into the ruck. So Lysette and Vardy started to get involved. As we see a few marks here, and Nathan Vardy late in the game to kick that goal. You know, when Collingwood kicked the first couple of the last quarter, that was a goal that kept West Coast in it.
It was crucial, buddy. Could you see him playing a role as he did in that game when you were a teammate of his at the Cats?
Well, he always had that capability to play as a forward first and then give some time in the ruck, and he certainly did that. But Scott Lysett's role, Brody Grundy. Now, Grundy was super with his actual ruck work, but then he almost turned into the biggest tagger we've ever seen, tried to nullify him around the ground.
Their marking ability right throughout the year, Damo, if they take over 90 marks, yep, they didn't lose a game, and they took 105 on yep the weekend.
Now, some of the framework for this grand final win of 2018 of the West Coast Eagles goes back to the end of 2007, when Chris Judd famously left the club. And you can see the transaction there. It's been played out throughout the entirety of that journey since. But the bit on the right side of the screen there, I think, places the West Coast Eagles with the balance of that ledger.
Yeah, it is. I don't think Carlton would regret the decision. They've loved what Chris Judd has done. He's still giving back to the football club. But you now look at in totality, Jimmy, and I think West Coast have won that one.
Yeah, I agree with both of you. It's been a win-win for both clubs. Mm. A couple of Juddy's finals were absolutely enormous. We still talk about them as great finals wins. Got some games out of Armfield, but also Chris Marston, nearly 200 games as well, and a premiership player.
Jimmy, you're best equipped here to talk about Norm Smith medal winners. Luke Stewart, it seemed to be a resounding right choice, didn't it?
Yeah, he was dominant for the whole entire game. And normally the Norm Smith goes to, you know, someone who's performed across the four quarters. And Luke Stewart certainly did that. And Lloydie touched on it. Where Collingwood was going to win was through their midfield power and strength. And this guy, he did everything in the game. 34 disposals, 19 of them contested, but the run and efficiency was 74%. 9 clearances, 8 tackles, 8 inside 50s. He certainly stuffed the stat sheet. And along with Dom Sheed as a running partner who did a lot of that the same. And then probably the other votes going in the game to Taylor Adams, because it was only a 5-point margin in the end. Yep. So Collingwood certainly had some winners as well.
Yeah, he had the most metres gained in the match. Dom Sheed didn't lay a tackle.
And even this moment here, Lord, he just whatever chance Collingwood had, he was there to stifle it.
Yeah, I think what's the greatest midfielders are those who can win it on the inside, and then he's just a brutal runner on the outside. It was a brilliant performance.
We've already seen Liam Ryan's role in that final last play that got the ball to Dom Sheed, but he had a moment that he'd like back, I think, before three-quarter time.
He did. You've just got to go here. And he didn't. He took his body off the line of the ball. Ace had pulled up. He didn't think he was going to get there. And this was just brilliant leadership from Lewis Jetta to say, OK, the scores are level. You can still impact this game, and he certainly did that, didn't he?
Yeah, obviously this mark will be played over and over, I guess, when we replayed this grand final. It was a super mark. He actually came from the front of the contest when you come back and have a look. He had another moment probably about 5 minutes before that, which led to the Josh Kennedy goal, where he had that composure and just sat the ball out in front. So, as coaches always say, you might be having a bad day, but don't have a really poor one. And he certainly did that. He still contributed to the
Both clubs endured adversity, didn't they, with injuries throughout the year. Nick Natanui, Brad Shepherd, Andrew Gaff unavailable for West Coast. Collingwood had to contend with a litany of problems too. And can they get back there in 2019 with what you saw in 2018?
Yeah, of course they can. I think that when you have a belief in your system and your coach and you're happy like they are, you can achieve anything, and they proved that this year.
Yeah, they certainly have the ability, and with the injuries, they've been able to play more players in different positions. Mm. So they've got actually a few different looks now that they can run into the next season. But as we know, nothing is guaranteed in this game. You know, the Crows would have thought they would have been straight back into the grand final. The Bulldogs won a premiership 2 years ago. Mm. You have to get better and keep improving and add layers to your game.
They played with Dare in that opening 20 minutes. They opened up a 29-point lead. And post-match, Nathan Buckley actually said they lost their Dare after half-time. What do you mean? What does he mean by that?
We called it together, Jim and I, and we felt that Mason Cox became really important for Collingwood because it was just long down the line. If Cox didn't mark it, well, then the ball was just going straight back into the Eagles' forward line. So after half-time, it was 38-16 inside 50s, and it was because the Eagles were running and carrying. Collingwood just going back behind the mark, and that's what I think Bucks was talking about.
Yeah, and a bit of I know Collingwood won the tackles, but West Coast actually won the inside 50 tackles by quite a lot. Yeah. So they were able to just pin it in their half. Yeah. But also the fatigue factor. You know, when West Coast took over 100 marks, as Lloydie was saying, that takes a lot out of your body, you know, running up, manning the mark, trying to defend. And then when you do turn it back, you don't have that energy to actually rebound the ball with the speed that we come accustomed to.
It was a game where you could piece together key moments to get the overall picture, didn't you? And one key moment came late in the third quarter. Elliot Yeo long bombed a big goal to put the Eagles in front. And it happened this way when the runner for Collingwood, Alex Woodward, got in the way of Jaden Stevenson. Now, there's no way of absolutely knowing if he would have got to the contest to spoil it. But what we do know is he would have been able to get closer than what he did.
Yeah, he would have got closer. And as you said, Damo, you can never fully know. But obviously, there's Nathan Buckley consoling him. Taylor Adams would be the one saying, you know, Alex, if my kick should have been better, it was a really poor option that I went for. And yeah, he should never blame himself for that.
And he's all class, Nathan. Yeah, he has been ever since he entered the AFL world, and that's him consoling Alex Woodward. He's got his own emotions to contend with, but he had time for others, even had time for others before the game, as he's about to go into a coaching a grand final for the first time, and the banner went down, Jimmy.
Yeah, it was the world's biggest banner. I feel sorry for it. They're the lifeblood of a footy club, the supporters and the members who get together during the week, and they build that banner, and this is their big moment, and they're all shattered, and Bucks takes his time out. He gives him a hug and tells this poor lady, it's okay, we'll get on with the game. So, look, shattered for the Collingwood cheer squad there, but I think we got it on camera what they were trying to achieve, didn't we?
Hey, Damo, as soon as the grand final is over and Monday comes around, we move to the trade period. Yeah. It's what excites a lot of clubs and supporters who didn't make the finals. What are we expecting?
Look, we'll get some clarity, won't we? Pretty quickly, I think, on McGovern getting himself to Carlton, how that takes shape. We will find out, I think, sooner rather than later. The intrigue to me, though, still centres around Gold Coast Suns and Stephen May's refusal to this moment, as we speak, to commit to that club, despite having the contract in 2019. It's a watch this space on his teammate Jack Martin. And look, another key one is the GWS players, Shield, Lobb, Scully. One or two of those three, I feel, will be making a move.
Jimmy, if you could have Scully or Shield, which one would you want? You're involved with the Brisbane Lions.
It's only a personal opinion. I like what Scully does. I like how he gets forward and uses the footy by foot and really breaks the line. Shield's a super player, so Can we take both? Can we have both?
Yeah. No, you're the one in that space. Yeah. Hey, Jimmy and Lotto, well done. Great year. I've really enjoyed Access All Areas this year.
Well done, David.
And well played. Yeah. And thanks for watching Access All Areas. We now switch, as Lloydie said, into player movement mode on afl.com.au with, of course, Trade Radio. And that's on right now. But also, don't forget our live video stream on the final day of the trade period, Wednesday, October 17. We're live from 5 p.m. It's not to be missed. Thanks for watching Access All Areas. Goodbye.